Okay, this is Ron Bell. If you need to get a hold of me, ronbellrealtor@gmail.com. If you have any questions, suggestions, anything to do with the playa, this is all just stuff of my own I've learned over the years. I don't know if you noticed or not, but this brings up a good point. The porta potty truck just went by. Sometimes what I'll do, and sometimes I'll even schedule my sleeping patterns around it, is I'll try to figure out the porta potty's, the pump out truck's schedule, okay? So as you're, you know, maybe you wake up at 10 and you know that the guy pumped it out at 9:30, you got some nice fresh porta potties. Now here is a very busy porta potty section because we're in a busy part of the city. So last night when I woke up, of course, I just hopped on my bike and I rode to the outskirts of the city, maybe out to, I don't know, N or something like that. N as in Nancy. And gosh, I even go out that far, who knows. Anyhow, I went out to where it's really quiet, nice fresh porta potty, plenty of toilet paper. So that's your tip of the day for the porta potties. Obviously, there's tons of videos about the whole porta potty etiquette. You know, just as they always say, if it doesn't come out of your body, don't throw it into the potty. What else? Be careful when you look down in there that your headlamp is securely tied on. Classic story I always like to tell is how my friend looked in there and his headlamp came on. And of course, you know, guess who had to reach in and get it for him? That's another story. Okay, so now, choosing a spot to camp. This is a very, very busy part of the city, if not the most desirable real estate in the whole entire city. You know, the Hollywood of Black Rock City, if you will. It's very close to the sound camps. It's very close to the free breakfast. It's very close to the free coffee and things like that. So what I did was I would kind of go around, and obviously you don't just go storming in there and start setting up camp. You want to ask, I call them a camp host, I don't know, but you always want to kind of just discreetly ask who the camp host is. Now, if you see some guy running around like a maniac with a radio on and totally stressed out, you may want to ask who the other camp host is, because sometimes they do shifts, okay? Because that guy a lot of times might not do you any favors. You also want to read license plate frames, okay? And nothing against Californians, love you guys and make a living off you guys, but if you can find the people from Oregon and Washington and avoid the, unless it's San Francisco, of course, they got a pretty good vibe down there, or somebody from Santa Cruz, for example, you know, surfers and things like that. You know, if you got some brand new car and with Marin County license plate frames, I think they're gonna really let you set your camp up in their camp. Nah, man, forget it. So just avoid the people with the nice cars with the license plate frames from expensive areas, and look for the Colorado license plates, you know, the people that have, you know, the states that are known for more of a gentler vibe. Ironically, aren't those the ones that Washington and Colorado that legal weed? Maybe that's why they just let me camp there. So I, this morning, spent about maybe 20 minutes introducing myself. I'd kind of give them a gentle hug, and then I'd proceed to tell my story, how much space I need, and I would, you know, offer them any help that I could give them in exchange for a little space. I actually scored this very nice spot next to an art car. Now, I'm going to be parked far enough from the art car so I don't risk getting run over. So right there where that vehicle's going by is where I'm going to camp. It's a nice exposure, okay? I should have good afternoon shade protection. So when I gift out my lemonade and my iced tea, it will be in the shade. Now, contrarily, if you're gifting pancakes, for example, in the morning, or coffee, you want your shade structure and your shade in general on the east side of the roads so that your guests have shade when they come into your camp. So the way the shade falls is relative to your activities. And of course, if you have an RV, you always want your entrance to the RV to be kind of on the north side, northeast side, you know, pure east. Pure east is probably better because typically you get a west wind. So now your RV will protect you from the wind, and it also creates shade. And then of course you line all your bins and ice chest along the bottom of the RV, and that creates your windbreak. So that's a little RV tip. Gosh, what else? I don't know, I just felt like making a video. It's not real dusty this year. We had all the rain. Oh, generators. That's another thing in selecting the site. okay? You want to, can you hear that? You want to be away from the noisy generator, all right? Now, that looks like maybe they've been to a couple burns before, maybe not. If it's a rental RV and they haven't been to a bunch of burns before, I would try to avoid those type of people, or that type of a scenario. I shouldn't say that the people are that bad, because they, you know, they're going to be running the generator 24/7. They don't probably have what's called generator etiquette and things like that. So, and generator etiquette is always thinking, okay, where's my exhaust go? Do I fire it up in the middle of the night? But that's a relative term. The middle of the night here in Black Rock City can actually be 9 in the morning. So, but just watch your generators. And then another rookie move is to set your tent or anything flammable too close to the exhaust. It'll either catch on fire or melt it. So that's the tip of the day. Hey man, how's it going?
Good man, how you doing?
Good, I'm just doing tips of the day for the playa. Do you have anything?
I'd say it's gonna get pretty hot, and the last couple days have been pretty rainy. It's not been too bad. So I'd say, you know, make sure to stay hydrated, because I think Wednesday, Thursday, Friday is gonna be a scorch, which is gonna be really nice. Yeah. But
Were you out here for the rain yesterday?
Yeah, I was. It was kind of crazy, because you know, it started probably around 3 a.m. and some of those lightnings were super close. It was really cool and really beautiful to watch, but it was different. So.
Now, did your camp get wet?
We got the two big tarps there. Yeah, so yeah. We set one up because the clouds were coming in and we kind of figured that was going to happen. And then we used the tarp to just cover everything we couldn't get under.
I was wondering, yeah, you know about the trench trick with the tarp?
Yeah,
trench trip. And also if you have a tent, actually I'm going to pan around here in a second. See, that's a good tent. You see how the plastic goes up the side of it?
Yeah.
Another thing you can do with tents, if you have the room, like a tent like that, on a wet year like this, is bring pallets out. You know,
yeah, definitely. Or
bare minimum have an air mattress, okay, and that'll keep you off. But boy, I tell you, a downpour like yesterday, you know, you also want that extra plastic tarp on it.
Yeah, if you're yeah. Just we, I think we were lucky not to get anything super wet.
Yeah, you know, I make a series of these every year, and so I just happen to kind of be talking about porta potties and finding camps and stuff. And I appreciate your time. What's
Very
your
cool,
name,
man? Nathan.
Nathan Todd.
Get on in here, big
guy. All right, man.
Yeah, good to see you.
Thanks, brother. That's it. We just happened to get a by guy and he's in a panda hat. Well, kind of a, I want to show you this tent here really quick and then we'll wrap it up. One of these days they're going to play this stuff at my wake and everybody's going to get a big kick out of it. All right. Maybe we'll talk about temple etiquette, by the way, on and what to do with ashes and things like that. All right, that tent right there. That's a good tent. It's not a Walmart. $29, at least I don't think it is. Do you see how that plastic goes up the sides a little bit? So what will happen here on the playa is the playa doesn't absorb moisture because it's, you know, I don't know what the, for lack of a better description, very clay-like, okay? And you see that plastic that goes up? Gosh, about 8 inches. That's very, very nice. So if you've got, you know, 3-4 inches of standing water, which it will, and that's why the playa was closed yesterday all day. That's a different video. That will protect you somewhat, okay? So you can do that. You can also have a piece of plastic that extends about 2 feet beyond your tent, okay? And then you either get playa dust or a 2x4 or something, and you form almost like a little donut or something, and you roll it back towards your tent, okay? If it's playa dust, for example, almost like somebody roll a joint, I guess. And then what that will do is that will create a little dam. So if you've got 4 inches of standing water, you want that dam to keep you out of there. Like I mentioned earlier to him, pallets work good too. That's providing you have the room. Most people in tents are usually traveling pretty light. All right, that's it. Hopefully my memory doesn't fill up. I'm talking about the camera, not me. RonBellRealtor.com. Ron Bell, realtor@gmail.com. Feel free to email me any questions or suggestions for the playa. Always love helping people out. 2014 burn.